Greetings, I'm Elizabeth Rowley, President and CEO of the Community Foundation of Orange and Sullivan. Typically this time of year, we'd be gathering together our many scholarship recipients, our donors and fund representatives, and our volunteers and board members who help make our scholarship program possible. While we're sorry to not be together in person, we extend our sincere congratulations to our over 100 scholarship recipients this year. Over $400,000 is going out from funds at the Community Foundation to support these students as they continue their educational journey at 2- and 4-year colleges and universities and trade schools around the country. We can never say thank you enough to our many donors, fund representatives, their family, friends, and supporters who give to these scholarship funds to ensure that students have these opportunities year after year. Over $400,000 is going out to these students this year, and we could not be prouder of all of the challenges that they've overcome recently and know that they'll continue to make us proud for years to come. We're also excited to share a couple of stories from two past scholarship recipients at the Community Foundation who we've stayed connected with, and they'll share a couple of words remotely that we hope will inspire and encourage you as you continue. Best of luck, everyone. Thank you very much for your support. Be well and stay safe.
On behalf of the Grinfeller Scholarship Fund, and as one of its first recipients, let me be one of many to congratulate you all on receiving this year's award and for all of your accomplishments up until this point. My name is Dr. Dan Marilia, and I knew Corinne Feller as a friend and fellow Valley Central High School classmate. She was bright, and she was kind, and she was a scholar athlete from Valley Central who embodied the best of what this award is meant to represent and who had her life taken from her when she was far too young by ovarian cancer. Receiving this award in her honor is a huge honor for you all, as it was for me over 20 years ago. I'm now having the privilege of trying to give you some advice as you all embark on your next journey in life. It's hard to believe that my journey beyond high school began two decades ago to places and experiences I never imagined. It has taken me from college to med school to the U.S. Army and now as a surgeon to El Paso, Texas. I have found my calling as a urologic surgeon, in many cases fighting cancer, and it's the legacy of people like Corinne who lost their battle to cancer that gives me the determination to help those in similar situations. As a doctor who has learned many lessons from my patients and their families, and in a polarized world that needs more healing, I'll give you three pieces of advice. Be kind. Value each and every moment you have on this earth and be grateful to your community. Don't forget where you've come from and all the people who need thanking for making this graduation of yours possible. Congratulations, class of 2020, and best of luck in whatever your future holds.
Hello and congratulations, graduates and Community Foundation Award recipients. I'm very sorry that your senior year hasn't been what you hoped, but the fact that you've been selected to receive this scholarship is a testament to your dedication and hard work, and I know you have a bright future ahead. In 2010, I graduated from Livingston Manor High School and was the recipient of the Lazar and Charlotte Kaplan Foundation Scholarship. From there, I studied business and marketing at the University of Delaware and can tell you firsthand this is an incredible opportunity, and to this day, I feel fortunate for how the Community Foundation helped me. While my professional journey is only just beginning, I'm excited and challenged every day as the Director of Marketing at Bethel Witt Center for the Arts. I attended my first concert, the Goo Goo Dolls, in 2006, and I looked up at the crowd as a wide-eyed 14-year-old saying, "I can't believe we have something like this in Sullivan County." Last year, as we celebrated the 50th anniversary of the Woodstock Festival, I looked out at a crowd of 30,000 saying, "Wow, I can't believe I'm a part of something this big." Every day I feel fortunate to not only contribute to an incredible organization, but be able to give back to the community that raised me. I wish you all nothing but the best and much success in your future.